planets of the morning. Welcome to Stargazers. I'm James Albury, director of the Kika Silva Plot Planetarium in Gainesville, Florida.
And I'm Dean Regas, astronomer from the Cincinnati Observatory, and we're here to help you find your way around the sky. Now, I'm not a morning person, but I'm going to set my alarm this week to wake up before dawn.
Really?
Yep. I can't believe I'm saying this, but I'm going to get up and drag myself out of bed at 5 o'clock in the morning to stargaze, or should I say planet gaze.
Wow, this is serious. And with good reason. As a morning person myself, I've been noticing three planets in the sky before the sun rises: Jupiter, Mars, and Saturn.
And to add some extra flavor to the astronomer-grade coffee I'm going to need to drink when I wake up that early, the moon will be passing through.
Perfect. Since it's not a work day, you can go back to sleep after you see it all.
My thoughts exactly. Let's head to the morning sky. Okay, we have our sky set up for Monday, March 5th at 5 a.m. facing southeast. It's dark, it's clear, it may be cold, but what a view.
Among the stars, you can find three planets among the constellations, and they're all lined up. Jupiter is about halfway up in the southern sky and is the easiest to find since it's the brightest.
That's an understatement. Jupiter is significantly brighter than any star at this time of night, morning. It is suspiciously bright.
If you have a really good imagination, you might be able to imagine Jupiter up and to the right of Scorpius the Scorpion. Scorpius is usually a summer constellation, but one of the joys of waking up early, Dean, is that you get to preview the stars.
That's right, James. And just to the left of Scorpius, we come to our next planet, and it should shine with a steady reddish glow. That is Mars. Now, you may notice another red star in the vicinity. Back in Scorpius, you can find Antares. Antares may look a little like Mars, but man, oh man, there are some big differences.
First off, notice the name of this star, Antares. Ares was the Greek god of war and the equivalent of the Roman god Mars. So Antares is like the anti-Mars. They're both the same color.
But that is where the similarities end. Mars is a planet about 4,200 miles wide and is about 125 million miles away. Those sound like impressive numbers, but...
Antares is a red supergiant star, almost 600 million miles in diameter and about 600 light years from the Earth. That's the equivalent of 3.5 quadrillion miles away.
Whoa! If we place Mars and Antares at the same distance from us, this is what they'd look like. Can you even see Mars?
That leaves one more planet to find, and Jupiter and Mars can help. Connect a line from Jupiter through Mars and keep going. You will run into another pretty bright star that should be a little yellow in color. That is actually the ringed planet Saturn.
Ah, my favorite. Saturn is about 1 billion miles away, but is so big and reflective that it still shines brightly in the morning skies.
And here's where it gets even better. If we advance our time to Wednesday, March 7th, look what joins the planet lineup.
The moon. It'll be right next to Jupiter. And then as the week progresses, on the 8th and 9th, the moon will get closer and closer to Mars, and on Saturday morning, March 10th, it will lie between Mars and Saturn.
And to round out next week, Sunday morning, March 11th, the moon will be just to the left of Saturn. Wow, what a week to get up early.
I love seeing the planets, even if it is at 5 a.m. And you'll see Jupiter in the south, Mars and Saturn in the southeast, and don't forget the moon passing through from March 7th to March 11th.
And if you can, take a look at all four objects through a telescope. The craters of the moon look totally awesome through even a simple telescope.
And with Jupiter, you can see stripes on the planet and four moons, some tiny features on Mars, and the breathtakingly beautiful rings of Saturn. It's all there when you
keep looking up.